What we're going to do today is create a bingo game for a classroom situation. We're going to create a basic multiplication game, and we do that by just going over here under Game Generators, under Mathematics, Basic Operations, and then we'll click Basic Multiplication. The data is automatically generated for you. You can see here we have the answers and the corresponding clues. And then we go over here and we can change some of the parameters. For this game, let's change the multiplicand to a range of 1 to 12. And we'll change the multiplier, say 5 to 9. And the new data is generated for us here. And then we can go to the card sheet view and take a look at what the cards would look like when they're printed out. We have 3 cards per piece of paper. If that can be changed, you can actually change this, the number of columns of cards per sheet to 5, the number of rows to 5, and you could squeeze 25 games onto one piece of paper. That gets a little bit tight for 8.5 by 11, so we'll change back to, for this our purposes, 1 column by 3 rows, so we have 3 cards per sheet of paper. You can also change the cards themselves by changing the number of columns and rows in each card. You can make an easier game for the students. For example, you could go 3x3, or a more difficult game by going 7x7. But again, for our purposes, our purposes will go back to 5x, sort of the typical bingo layout is 5x5. And you can change, by default, the students have the answers on their cards. You can simply click visible elements and click clues, and then they have the clues on their cards, and you would then call the answers. For example, you would call it, say, 27, and they're looking for 3 times 9. And then on the call sheets, there are a number of cosmetic things you can change, fonts and colors and things like that. And then the final thing is to look at is the call sheet view, and this is what is printed out for you, so you can call the game, and you can just simply check the items off as you go. You can call 90. Students are looking for 10 times 9 on their cards. I guess the only other thing is to make sure that we're printing out enough cards. So by default here, I think it's 10. But if we had a class of 25, we want to make sure we have 25 sets of card sheets. And you can see we've got one of 25. You can flip through them, take a look at them if you like. Each one is different. And that's basically it. You're ready to print out and play the game.